Hey there everyone, this is Shadigo and welcome back to Jet Set Radio. We're starting chapter 2 in this one, and I'm doing this first part post-commentary. Mainly because, stuff is happening. It wasn't necessarily the first part, but, the second part with Kama was being a real pain. This game was hating me a lot when I was doing these recordings. This is why the late and then ended up coming up on the same day. But yeah. The thing about these two recruitment things is that, I'm probably going to say it in live cameras wrong in case you forget, but these, because they are story based, you will be doing them whenever you play New Game Plus. As for the levels in Chapter 2, you're also only going to be able to play as Combo and Kim initially, but once you've beaten the game going through a New Game Plus, you can actually go ahead and play as any character. So you can bring Gum or someone to like the next two stages that we're doing, so you can get jet ranks. And getting jet ranks on these two levels on this particular area actually unlocks probably one of the best guys to do it, getting jet ranks on repeat based levels. Now yeah, my problem here is with Combo's thing, because Combo's thing is a race. And Combo isn't the fastest Rudy around the block. Normally I can actually do this one first try, but it took me like about 6 or 7 tries altogether. But yeah, you start the bus terminal, and it looks like you can just go straight for the tag, but the game won't let you, so you've got to go Rudy through Park Street, through the sewers and down the hill area, and to claim your prize. And you're actually also going to see a cut here, because I'm only going to be showing the successful attempts. You can actually get to a header beat right here. The best way of doing it is just do the little trick of doing a dash and then jump. Also, when you get to this area here, do a jump before the transition, otherwise the control system is going to screw you over. That's happened a few times, and that's been a cause of a few losses. I think this run I pretty much did perfect, apart from, I was going to say apart from here, where I face planted. Not that Combo minds getting a face plant to the face, because of all that health. He's actually probably one of the best people for some of the later stuff we'll be doing if he's struggling really, really badly. And I will be using him multiple times aside from this chapter. So if you're going to complain that I'm not using certain characters, well, that's why. Anyway, this has been the problem for me. I've been trying to jump into that gate. Sometimes the game thinks I can put the mess, and if I don't get that first try, then Beat's gonna take, gonna pass me. And if Beat passes me around here, then I've pretty much lost. Also, getting hit by a car, especially the ones that are going up the hill, is also instant doom. Yeah, I actually did this one first try, which is pretty great. Well, not really first try, it was like about 8 or 9 tries. But now Combo is actually going to share with you a little bit of a storyline, and after that I am going back to live commentary. So I will see you back then.
Grind City, my turf. My name's Combo, and me, Cube, and Coin used to own the Bantam Street area in this city. It's a little far from Tokyo, but everyone used to stay out of our way there. Till recently, that is. Someone been going around painting these ugly signs all over Grind City. It's so ugly I can't even call it graffiti. Strange paintings of rhinos and bizarre symbols. All of our old graffiti has been covered up by these horrific signs. And on top of that, Coin has been kidnapped and his enormous collection of records has been destroyed. Ever since the emergence of these paintings, strange things have been happening in this city too. Unfamiliar black cars and men in black suits are hanging around the streets as if they're waiting for something. Now wait, was that statue here at Grind Square always this color? There's definitely something wrong here. I smell something fishy going on.
Hello, what's that old soccer? I am back with live commentary. And if I didn't say it in post commentary, those challenges, you have to do them all the time when you're playing this game, even if you're playing on a loop back in your game boss. So yeah, that's the thing. Also, a thing that only affects when you play this game the first time is that the street menu is basically a picture of Cambo Cuban Karen here. You can actually see, you can still see the street map from the other thing, but we're actually in another area. I've also changed the graffitis, all these are cubes designs, because that's what we're going to be using for this first section. Also, for the first time you're playing this game, you can only play Chapter 2 as either Cambo or Cube. I think it's sort of semi-justified, seeing as it's a flashback to 2 months ago, when they started having trouble. But when you come back to this New Game Plus, you can actually come back with whatever character if you want to get jet ranks, because the 2 levels you get in this chapter, I believe, unlock one of the best unlock characters in the game, in my opinion. Well, to an extent, but that's just an insane detail. Anyway, we're going to play with Cube here. I believe her stats are pretty much the same as Beak's, except there's 2 exceptions. I think she's a little faster than Beak. And, oh no, it's playing Dragula straight away. I'm gonna get double right hit straight away, aren't I? Usually, my recipe for the perfect afro here. Which is rather interesting. I believe this song actually wasn't in the original Jet Set Radio version of this. The game. I think mine's been exclusively checked out on the radio. Oh, I almost could have lost him anyway. But anyway, Cube can hold max 25 square cast, unlike Beak, which can only hold 20, I believe. My strats for this level are fairly simple. Try to get all the ones on the bruise here fairly quickly, because the guy that shows up on the radio wants him. The most trouble you'll have with him will be on the roof here. Also, don't mind the fact that people are shooting you up here. They can only see you on the right road by the fact that you're up there. They won't actually get you. Unlike later where you'll be painting and there will be problems there. Also, this area here is probably, in my honest opinion, best place to do trying 100 tricks between do a jump quick wall ride and then just quickly do more ball ride, and eventually you'll get 500. I mention this because there's actually an achievement in the HD version of the game. We go do some tricks. The only other decent place would be probably Scuba Station, because there's an easy way to do an infinite trick loop draw. And I think it's really necessary to actually do that when you're playing tutorial, which I'm probably also going to show off in the next video. I also got one of the small tags over there, which is like a ball ride from the petrol station side to a spray. That's also another awkward one to get. There is actually an extra large one on the big arrow there between the train tracks. That's usually the last one I actually go for, incidentally. The reason being is that trains go past there every so often and whilst you're painting. And I don't really want to be around there. But once this shows up, the Assassin number 5 here. Once he shows up, the train stops spawning. So here's Assassin number 5. He jumps around on the roofs and he will attack you with that baton whip thing. But if you stay away from the roofs, it's not that much of a problem. And yeah, there's also two large tags which I don't get, so I think that's probably the best tag to get. Because hopefully there's going to be no golden rhinos trying to kill me. Train stop for being contradicted to what I've said. Now aside from that big one up there, I think the rest are just small tags. So that's pretty great. I actually need to more square things because I need at least seven. I need 7 for the large. And I think all these ones here are just like singles. There's a couple though that are pretty tricky to get. Which I'm hopefully going to get to. Yeah. Also, the skate park here is probably the best place to grab your spray cans. Except there's also an assassin over here, so you might want to be careful. Oh, it's actually playing different remix. It's actually the first time I've heard this mix as well, because usually the mix it plays is the same one it plays for the original Jesse Radio. Also, going up the building up here, there's also going to be machine gun. There's going to be machine gun people there going to cause some problems. I try and go this way, maybe I shall get some things. That one's also an awful thing to get, so... And yet, for some reason, I'll get it close to my make a liar of myself. I think the only one left is the extra large one at the railway station, the Twin Rail Tracks. Which is absolutely fine because nobody's going to touch you off. Rest assured, no one will touch you off. Just, you know. And hopefully I should get a jet rack because you can get a jet rack with Cube on this level. I have done this before. I actually did it in my series playthrough with Gab. Actually, when I first played the HD remake, which is the version I'm playing, yeah, I actually did the first try with Cube as well. And there you go. You can get around with Cube and Cube on this one. It's not a problem. It's going to be the second one that's going to be a problem. So time for my exposition on chapter 2.
There was a message on a piece of graffiti. I think it was from Coin. He told me to go to Grind Square. It seems like the punks that have been painting those ugly pieces of art have been hanging around Grind Square too. They probably already know that we've been painting over their stuff with our own symbols. They may be dangerous, but we can't let them take over. It's time to throw a little spray paint party and see if they come and try to crash it.
And there we go, that's the first episode of the first two parts of chapter 2. So, in the next episode, we'll be taking Combo and we're going to throw a little spray paint party, just like you said. Thankfully, this take extra length is back to the dead because when I was doing Phantom Ship 4, I actually got the part by one of the gold rhinos, so I had to restart everything over, including Cuban Combo's. Intro the combo and cube challenges. That's the one part of it. Yeah, because this thing just texted off to say that they're, it just didn't give you an option to manual save, and it doesn't auto save when you get the new characters, which kind of stinks. Especially that all over again, and Campbell's very frustrating me again, and I'm kind of glad that that's out of the way, I'll be honest. So yeah, Campbell's Straight Fate Party, next episode, see you later guys, ciao!